Andrea had the most behavior points this spring, so she brought in her favorite film. Wish it ain't so. Interesting. Please don't tell your parents.
Luckily, they didn't. But why would that be the first line of anything? I just want to reward my students for a good first half of school year by showing them a good first half of movie. I signed up to teach choir, but I'm somehow now both a film critic and censor, trying to figure out, can something that avoids violence or swearing ever be considered great art?
I don't know.
You're probably now thinking, why not just put on the latest comedy special of a popular ventriloquist? That would put me in danger of getting fired as well, for showing the students something that could be deemed political. Because as you and I both know, all ventriloquists are overtly Republican. That's why I got so nervous last month when Gabriel did his lunch performance. A long story. But basically, we give him the last 5 minutes of lunch each month to perform for the other students. His decision to not talk through the puppet, but instead recreate the title sequence of Caddyshack was, to put it bluntly, a freaking relief.
Gabriel. After, I spoke with Gabriel, and he shared his thoughts on the connection between conservatism and ventriloquism. It's fairly obvious to observe, but I still haven't figured out why.
I've got theories, but the nicest of them is it's a throwback to old times. In fact, ventriloquism can even be traced back to ancient Greece, ancient Egypt.
I didn't know that.
But make this thing talk? Never. Modern ventriloquism is the oppression of puppets.
So right, my man. People are thrilled by the spectacle of a puppet speaking, but only with constant reassurance that it's not actually speaking by always having a hand up its back. It's very...
I feel this applies to ventriloquism post-1960, when puppets were liberated by Jim Henson and allowed to exist as autonomous Muppets.
Huh.
If Jeff Dunham, Terry Fader fans saw Kermit the Frog riding a bicycle, they would cry blasphemy, then bludgeon it, because something so free and beautiful should not be allowed to exist.
Oh, Gabriel, how do you know about Caddyshack?
Oh, it was one of the three videos we had at the Hitopa research base.
Oh,